Hi, in this video, I'm going to teach you the desktop computer part. So you will understand in this video all about desktop computer part and circuit. So let's get started. So here, as you can see, we're gonna work on OptiPlex 7020. This is basically i5 core processor. So this is do power supply, as you can see over here. Over here we have the processor. This is the fan for the processor, and over here we have the heatsink. Okay, so this is the memory. As you can see, the random access memory. Okay, 4 slots over here, and the power of the memory is written on the slot of memory. So let's check. As you can see here, we have 1.5 volt. So 1.5 volt. Is for the DDR3 RAM, okay? DDR3 RAM, as you can see in the screen. So 1.5 volt for DDR3. So always, if you want to check the RAM power, you should check the slot of RAM. So here, this is the hard disk. So the power supply basically gives two kind of power to the motherboard. The general power, as you can see here, for the whole motherboard, and the power for CPU, as you can see, 4 connectors. So the yellow here, the yellow cable is 12 volt. This is basically for the fan, okay? So two kind of volt, one for the motherboard and the other for the CPU. So this is basically an IC, okay? Here we have a CMOS battery, here we have electrolytic capacitor. This is inductor or coil. Here we have another inductor, this is MOSFET, as you can see. So this is the BIOS, the basic input output system, okay? Always you will find the IOs near to the CMOS battery. Here we have, as you can see, other electrolytic capacitor. This is MOSFETs, a 3-terminal MOSFET. And here we have 8-terminal MOSFET. And this is the connector, of course, for the power. So this is the SATA connector, serial ATA connector, as you can see, where the HDD, the hard disk drive, and other are connected. This is basically the SATA or serial ATA connector, looks like, as you can see. And here we have the connector for power. Okay, so for each equipment it needs a SATA connector and a power connector. So here, as you can see, this is inductors. These small components are inductors, as you can see. This is ceramic capacitor. Here we have resistors, as you can see, the small component, and here we have inductors. Okay, this is inductors. The reference for inductors is L. So this is basically the ICH, the input-output control hub, as you can see. So near to the ICH, we have a crystal oscillator. You will find always near to the ICH, a crystal oscillator, as you can see. So here we have an electrolytic capacitor, MOSFET, and we have other MOSFETs, 8-pin MOSFETs. So under the heatsink, we have the processor, the notebook, and the graphic card. So three chips connected together or integrated together. Okay, the processor, the graphic card, and the notebook. And over here, as you can see, we have the ICH separated. So here we have basically some ports. So here, as you can see, we have this is external port. Basically, we use this port to connect external card, like the graphic card, the USB card, the network card, etc. Okay, so here, this is the CPU circuit. As you can see, we have 3 channels for the CPU. We have 3 electrolytic capacitor and 3 inductors, as you can see. Okay, and of course, MOSFETs. We have MOSFETs here next to this electrolytic capacitor and inductors. Means this CPU basically has 3 channels. Okay, this is the first channel. Here we have the second channel, and over here we have the third channel. Okay, and here this is the power for the CPU. This is the power for the CPU. This is another inductor, as you can see, inductor that adjusts the current for the CPU. Always you will find next to power in the inductors. Always electrolytic capacitor and inductor should be in every circuit. So this is crystal oscillator. We have another crystal oscillator, and this is basically an IC. Okay, this is for the CPU, and we have, of course, here we have an IC. This is audio IC. This is for audio, basically. Okay, I see for audio to control the audio control. And here, as you can see, we have the beeper or the buzzer. This is beeper, as you can see here, or buzzer. So here, as you can see, this is the HDD. It has two connectors. This is the for power and for data SATA connector. Okay. So this is it, guys. I hope that you understand a little bit the part, the desktop part. So this is basically the main part. So thank you very much. And please don't forget to subscribe, share, and like the video. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video.